LearnCube contains a number of Wolfram Alpha based maths tools and scientific tools, and to be able to use those, all I need to do is click the plus icon bottom right here for lesson materials and click on the maths tools item here. Now it's going to let me search for anything in this formula. And whilst it does say formula, if I was to search for something that had a scientific element to it, it would show me information about that. Now, what I'm going to be doing here is actually looking at the Wolfram Alpha language system, which is available at reference.wolfram.com/language. And you'll find a whole host of interesting things you can try in LearnCube. If I click on the symbolic and numeric computation, and then let's go and look at equation solving and click solve, it's going to give me a whole load of options here and explains me how to use the solve tool here. Now, what I'm actually going to go down is look down here at quadratic equations and click here to copy this to my clipboard. Now, if I come back to LearnCube and put in here the solve equation and click search, it's going to search Wolfram Alpha, and you can see that it's found that result there. And if I click on this result, it's actually going to show me not only the answer, but also the result, which is zero. So I can then load these in if I want to. I don't need the zeros, so I'm just going to load in x equals zero and solve this equation and show it in a nicer way and add those images directly to the whiteboard. So there we go, we have both the result and the formula itself at the top. So I can also use LearnCube to complete some maths equations for me, or to understand something such like a prime number. So I can just use this tool here. So next prime, and then square brackets, the number that I want it to count up from. So if I go into Add Lesson Materials, go to Maths Tools, next prime is in there, let's choose a higher number. Let's say after 1023, what is the next prime after that? So it's going to search Wolfram Alpha, there's my equation result. So if I click here, you can see this is the formula. This is the next prime, which is 1039. Here it is on a graph. Here it is in text. Here it is expressed as a decimal. I also have the equations to discover that it's a prime. So I can load any of these in, or let's load a series of those in as well. Great. So now I can discuss with the student all of these different options here for understanding the results.